Bizzibox's expert information on living with dogs. How often do I need to walk my dog?
Well, dogs obviously need exercise, and you should be prepared to give some time of your day to exercising. Now, some small dogs may be perfectly content being exercised in the garden, but I would say that all dogs do go out to like to go out to explore. They like to go around the neighbourhood. They like to meet people, like to meet other dogs. It's good for their socialisation. The amount of exercise a dog requires is dependent, of course, on the size of the dog and the type of dog. Some dogs need more exercise, and again, you can find that out from the breed of the dog, find out what that dog's requirements are. But as a general rule of thumb, I would say most dogs will need at least half an hour a couple of times a day. Some will need more than that, some will need less, but that's a good rule of thumb.
Where should I walk my dog?
Most areas have an area that you, even built-up areas, do have local parks, but find out before you buy your dog where you can exercise the dog. If you live in a more rural area, of course, the range is much wider. But again, of course, farmland, for example, they may have restrictions on walking dogs. So find out where your the good local areas are for walking your dog, but you will be able to find somewhere.
Do I need to clean up after my dog?
Wherever you are, always pick up after your dog. There are certain areas that prefer you not to because they say the environmental impact of actually picking up after, even in a very rural area, if you pick up after your dog, you're actually doing more environmental damage by putting it in a plastic bag. But always take plastic bags in your pocket so you can pick up after your dog. It's not very nice, even for other dog owners, to have to walk where other dogs have messed.
Can I go on holiday if I have a dog?
Of course you can go on holiday if you have a dog. These days we have the pet passport system, so you can even take dogs abroad with you now, providing the dog's microchipped and fulfills all the requirements. Most places will take dogs, but you have to be aware that some places won't. If you find you want to go on holiday to somewhere where you can't take your dog, and certainly if you're going on a plane, you're very unlikely to be able to take your dog. So you'd have to find a reputable boarding kennel who can look after your dog, or have someone come into your home for that couple of weeks and look after your dog in your own home. That's often the best solution.
How do I get a pet passport?
The first place to look is look at the DEFRA website. That has all the rules and regulations, but also go to your vet. Your pet will need to be microchipped and will need to have certain inoculations. For instance, a rabies inoculation it will have to have if it's going to be issued with a pet passport. And you can't travel immediately. If you want to travel with your pet, you've got to allow at least 6 months because an antibody test has to be done once the vaccination has been given to make sure that the vaccine has been effective. So it's something you should plan in advance. And if you do plan to take your pet abroad, then visit the vet at the very earliest opportunity to actually take part in the passport system.
Can I take my dog on public transport?
Yes, most public transport do allow dogs. It can be at the driver's discretion. And I would say get your dog, if you plan to do it on a regular basis, do it when the puppy is early, get the puppy used to going on public transport. Most pets will actually quite enjoy travelling with you.
Who can look after my dog when I'm on holiday?
If you don't want to take your pet abroad, then of course there are many licensed boarding kennels and your local authority may have a list of those. But you can also get people to look after your dog, and the internet's a great place to look. There are many organisations or even friends and family that will come and look after your dog. I personally prefer to leave the dog at home and have someone looking after it. But there are many good licensed boarding kennels out there. Go to one that's got a good reputation and go and have a look at it first. Make sure the kennels are nice and clean and make sure it's somewhere you think you would like to leave your dog for a couple of weeks.
What do I need to consider if I'm moving house?
When you're moving house, think this is going to be a big change in your dog's life, and the last thing you want to do is to upset your dog. The first thing is make sure the garden is secure, because a dog, if you move a dog from one environment to another and just let it go, he may get completely disorientated and not know where he is. So the first thing is make sure he's in a secure environment, but also do it a stage at a time if you can. If you're going to move house, get all your furniture in first before you bring your dog in, because the dog will then have familiar things around it and have more idea that he's there to stay, rather than suddenly moving him in with all the activity of what's going on at the same time.
What should I feed a puppy?
There are many different types of dog food out on the market. But the dog's requirements do change as they get older. So the first thing is they will probably require a puppy food if it's a young dog. But take advice from the breeder, because the breeder will have started on a certain type of food, and it's a good idea to keep along with that food for a period of time. If you want to change the diet at a later date, then you should introduce it slowly. But try and keep the dog on what it's been on from its first few weeks of life.
What should I feed an adult dog?
Once a puppy's off his puppy food and gone to an adult food, try and find a food that's convenient for you, that you like and clearly that the dog likes. As a dog gets older, they may need a change in its diet. They may go on to a more senior food, a lower protein food, because its exercise requirements will be different and the amount of protein and amount of nutrients it has will change as the animal gets older. So take advice. There are lots of many reputable dog foods out there, proprietary foods that are, there's a whole wealth of them out there. But take advice, see what works for you, what works for your dog. But again, I would say take advice from the breeder, because they will know what sort of food suits that type of dog.
What is the difference between dry and wet food?
Well, there's no effective difference between dry and wet food other than the moisture has been taken out of the dry food. A dog should always have water available at all times, and that's particularly important if you're feeding a dog a dry diet. Lots of the foods out there are what we call kibble, which is this dry pellet type food. That's very, very good, very good levels of protein. There's lots of different manufacturers making it these days. But you can feed a dog a vast range of food, right from fresh food, from fresh chicken, fresh meat, right the way up, all sorts of whole different range of foods. But take advice from the breeder about what that breeder's dog's been fed on, and you'll find that they'll probably do very well on that.
How much and how often should I feed my dog?
Obviously, a dog's dietary requirements changes with the amount of activity it has and the age of the dog. Most manufacturers will give you some guide to how much food you should be giving it, but it's a lot of it is visual. Most people can tell if their dog is too fat or too thin, and if it's too thin, you give it a bit more food, and if it's too fat, you give it less food. I find looking after a dog's diet is far easier than looking after my own diet, because it's much more easy to stop a dog eating than it is to stop myself eating. But if you have any doubts, seek your vet's advice. A vet will tell you whether the dog is too fat or too thin.
Do I need to supplement my dog's diet?
A dog should have a balanced diet. You can't just give a dog meat, for example, without giving it other things as well. Most of the proprietary foods, the dry foods, the tinned foods, are a complete food in their own, and you don't need to feed other foods with it. Some wet food you may need to feed biscuit with as well. But the food should be balanced, and take advice. The manufacturers will give you advice on how that food should be balanced. There are other supplements you can add, particularly if you're feeding fresh chicken or fresh meat and biscuit, then you should actually give supplements with that as well. But pet food manufacturers and the supplement manufacturers would advise you on that.
Can I give my dog table scraps?
There's absolutely nothing wrong with giving your dog table scraps as an addition to its diet, but not too much. A big change in diet can upset a dog's stomach. A little bit a day is no harm at all, and most dogs will enjoy that. But you can't just feed a dog on table scraps. Table scraps alone is not enough.
Can I give my dog bones?
You can give your dog bones. Mostly marrow bones, the big chunky bones, are the best ones to give a dog because they won't tend to break bits off. Small bones are no good for dogs at all. If they can bite bits off the bone and swallow them, they can do them lots of harm. There are lots of other things you can give a dog other than bones these days. There are things like these. These look like bones, but they're actually made of nylon or plastic. Very hard, very good for the dogs. Help to clean their teeth, and they don't have some of the dangers that that bones have, that they can't actually chew bits off these.
What toys are good for my dog?
Well, there are lots of toys out there on the market. What you should try not to do is leave a dog alone with a toy for too long. Toys like this, for example, you can see this has seen better days, but I wouldn't leave something like that alone with a dog because it can chew bits of it off and can swallow it, and then that leads to problems. Toys like this, hard rubber toys, are much safer. The dog can't chew bits off it. They make very, very good toys. Of course, squeaky toys. Puppies love squeaky toys. But again, they shouldn't be left with these. They can chew bits off them. They tend to get the squeaky out and swallow them. So have to be a little bit careful with those.
Why do dogs need toys?
Dogs are like people, they need toys, they need entertainment, and they enjoy them, they enjoy playing. It's part of their activity, part of what they do. They really enjoy, they chase balls. It's part of their natural instincts to actually, in the wild, of course, dogs will be hunting, so they'll chase something, and chasing a ball is good activity, but they love a game. The more activities you do with a dog, the more it's going to have a long and happy life.
www.bizzybox.com